All right. Welcome, welcome everybody again to this episode of whatever this is. My name is Barrett. I'm a record producer. Today I'm going to react to D4DV, or is that just a interesting spelling of David, maybe? Can somebody please tell me this? Romantic Homicide. So I was going through Spotify Top 50 and just kind of listening to it. I really didn't like that new country thing at number 10. And then there was like, I was really interested to see September there, Earth, Wind & Fire, back on the charts as it was, which I actually really love that song. And then I was listening and heard this song, Romantic Holiday. I didn't listen to the whole thing, but I was really liking the sound. It didn't sound like anything else on there. I thought it was cool. The sounds were cool, totally distorted lo-fi drums, just a nice haunting melody. So I thought I'd do a reaction to it. But first, let me read a little bit from Billboard. I tried to find out who this guy was. Singer-songwriter David scores his first entry on the Billboard Hot 100 charts. The Billboard Hot 100 charts, by the way, is kind of not real nowadays. It doesn't mean anything. You know what means something is the Spotify charts, because that's where people are listening to music. With his breakthrough single, Romantic Homicide, the genre-bending song released July via Darkroom Interscope, so he got signed to a major label, debuts at number 77 with 6.8 million U.S. streams, which is up 20% in the September 2 through 8 tracking week. It received a boost from the September 7th premiere of the official video. That is what I will be doing this review on. This song initially drew buzz thanks to TikTok. I think I'm going to do another video about how TikTok is really the driver of a lot of bands getting signed to major labels, because major labels now just look at TikTok and see what goes crazy. Like, there was a whole Vox piece on this. I can't remember the name of the guy. He had a million something hits on TikTok where he just made up some bullshit and got signed. I don't know. It was bad. Where the song has been used in more than 245,000 clips. Yeah, 17-year-old Houston native, real name David Burke. Oh, there you go. It's David. David is not just a newcomer to the Billboard charts, but to the music scene entirely. He arrived with his initial release Turned Up in December, and Romantic Homicide is now his first charting hit. Interesting. So I was just speaking with a client the other day who I've just finished producing and recording and working with her on her first song that she's ever worked with anyone else on. Very talented 17-year-old, another 17-year-old from North Carolina, who she and her dad were asking how do they get radio play? And I was like, radio play? Nobody listens to the radio anymore. You need to be on Spotify or YouTube and TikTok, and that's how music is found nowadays. And they were very resistant. She has zero web presence whatsoever. And you know, I didn't know what to tell them. There are marketing people that maybe can do that for you, but really nowadays people want direct connections with their artists, and you kind of have to put yourself out there, you know, in a direct way with your fans to hopefully get noticed. All right, so let's check out David, spelled D4VD. And before we do, please like and subscribe and make some comments down there. Tell me what you think of this. And yeah, I appreciate it. All right. Without further ado, Romantic Homicide. What I like about this is how it's kind of indie sounding it is. I mean, it sounds like a lo-fi drum kit recording, like maybe real. The guitars are definitely real. His voice is definitely real. Very simple two-chord song right now. Nice kind of cool arpeggiating guitar part. I don't know where they were getting the goth thing from. It doesn't really sound goth to me, but it sounds more indie. Yeah. Why am I still here? I don't need to be complacent with the decisions you made, but why? Wow, this is reminding me of something, and I don't know what, but anyway, it feels to me like this is a self-produced thing. I'm very curious if anyone knows who was the producer on this. I'd love to know more. A great example of a two-chord song and how to milk it and make it interesting. It's all about where his voice is going and intensities and phrasing and notes. I love that it's only 2 minutes and 30 seconds long. That is awesome. The length a pop song should be. Yeah, I really like that song. Gives me hope for the future of music that it's in the Spotify top 10 right now. I'm liking that. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments and stuff. All right. Until next time, thanks.